Hello, brothers and sisters. I hope you're all doing well and you had a blessed Thanksgiving with your families. As I'm sure you know, December 3rd, Sunday, begins the season of Advent and, in fact, begins our liturgical year. So I want to spend a few minutes just talking about Advent and the things that we can expect. We know, of course, that the season of Advent is a preparation for the celebration of Christmas. But there's also a focus in the season of Advent on reflecting on the second coming of Jesus. The second coming when he will come to judge the living and the dead. This is what we say in our creed. St. Bernard has this beautiful reflection in which he talks about the three comings of Christ. And he said that the third coming is kind of sandwiched in between his first and his second coming. And he says that a heart that is open and dedicated to the Lord will find within itself the Lord dwelling there. And this is what we call an encounter. And so, really, brothers and sisters, what my prayer is for you is that in this season, you experience this encounter with the Lord Jesus. I've often said that the season of Advent is one that we kind of have to fight for, because everything in our culture and our society kind of militates against any kind of preparation other than the practical ones. And sometimes it can be hard to take time for spiritual reflection because everything's so busy. And yet, I encourage you, brothers and sisters, to really fight for it. So what can we do? One thing that we'll have is that we're going to have this Advent prayer card that will be available at all the masses. And I invite you to pray this prayer every day as a preparation for the Lord's coming. Some way to set aside some time in your day to pray. I also want to encourage you to attend our Advent Evening of Reflection, which will be Wednesday, December 6th. We'll obviously have our 5:30 Mass, and I encourage you to attend that if you can. And then at 6:30, we'll begin a couple of hours of just reflection. We'll have a meditation, a guided meditation. I'll give a little Advent reflection, and then we'll have time for Eucharistic adoration, some praise and worship, and Father Josh and I will be available for confession. And so as your pastor, I really encourage you to make it a priority to attend that. As I said, brothers and sisters, my prayer for you in this season is that your hearts will be open to receiving the Lord Jesus, encountering him, and being transformed by his love. God bless you.